maybe not here in Victoria, elsewhere, everybody wants to come to church that day. Even those who are not Christians want to be in church because they want to cross over to the new year. So during this the crossover, the new year, we made so many resolutions. We made a lot of promises. God, I don't want to do this again. I don't want to do that again. This is what I want to do this year. So we made a number of resolutions and a number of promises that we want to achieve in the course of the year. And we also ask for blessings. We ask for so many things. But before we get to June, what happens? We are unable to achieve most of the resolutions and the things we say. So, beloved in Christ, we have to pay attention to what God is saying to us. We are not able to achieve all the promises and the resolutions and what we set for ourselves since the beginning of the year because we are not paying attention to what God is saying to us. When we were making our resolutions, we were unable to listen to God. So we were just asking. We couldn't ask God, what do you want for me this year? Most of the time we forget to do that. God, what do you want for me this year? But instead we ask Him, what I want. I want to do this, I want to do that. So where do you want me to be this year? What do you want for me this year? And what do you want for me this year? So what do you want for my children this year? I wonder how many people ask that, made that resolution. How many of us made that resolution? So all we were asking was, God, do this for me. Do that for me. And I want to do this. So whenever we are unable to listen to God, we run into vocation crisis. So God is constantly calling us every day. But because we are so busy and we are so preoccupied with ourselves, we can't hear what God is communicating to us. So in the first reading, we read from the book of Samuel, we heard Samuel saying to God, speak Lord, your servant is listening. Samuel got his vocation from his mother. We remember his mother prayed and God listened to her. And she said, if you give me a child, I will give the child back to you. And she was faithful and gave him back Samuel to God. So Samuel, to this very time, didn't know what he was into. He was dedicated to God by his mother. He never knew what he was doing in the house of Eli, the priest. He was just living with his master, Eli, the priest. Scripture says Samuel didn't know yet the voice of the Lord, and he had not heard God before. So God spoke to him. God was calling Samuel. Because Samuel didn't know God, Samuel couldn't determine who was calling. Who is it that was calling? He ran into his master, he went to Eli in the middle of the night and said, you are calling me, I'm here. But Eli said, go back to your sleep. So he took the intervention of Eli, the priest, to help Samuel to listen for the voice of God. And we see the similar thing in the gospel today, the gospel reading today. Those two men who were standing and talking with John the Baptist. We are told one of them was angry. We don't know the name of the other person. And for them, they have found the person they were looking for, Baptist, John the Baptist. Not until John the Baptist pointed at Jesus and said, that is the man. So it is for him that I came. So they left John and followed Jesus. Someone needed Eli to identify God. And the two disciples also needed John the Baptist to identify Jesus Christ. And Simon Peter also needed his brother Andrew to identify Jesus Christ. So in all these, to identify Jesus, there must be a mediation. We see in the reading, there must be a mediation. There must be somebody who is there helping us to identify God, to identify the voice of God. To be with God, there must be someone between us and God who is helping us constantly. So if Eli, the priest, was not there, someone wouldn't have identified God. In the same way, if John the Baptist was not there, those two men would not have known who they were following, Jesus Christ. Because it was John that pointed to Jesus, and the two disciples followed. There are vocation crises now because those who are supposed to be mediators are not doing what they are supposed to do. They are not doing what they are supposed to do. Those who are supposed to direct us to know God, to identify the voice of God, they are not doing that. We are not paying attention to our roles as mediators, the role of leading others to God, for them to identify the voice of God. And so, I'm a priest, and my work and my role is to lead others to God, to serve as a bridge for people to connect to God. Just as you are a father or a mother or a leader, or whoever you are to lead as a mother and as a father. You are to lead your children where God wants them to be. We are also mediators, helping our children to identify the voice of God. So a father, a mother, a leader, anywhere we find ourselves, we are to lead others to God. Christians, wherever we find ourselves, whether in our workplace, whether on the streets, wherever, we are to lead others to God. To lead others to God, we must be men and women of patience. To lead others to God, we must be men and women of patience. Eli was very patient with Samuel. He came to Eli. Someone came to Eli three times. The first time, Eli said, "No, I'm not calling you." The second time, he sent him. And each of these, Eli was not angry with Samuel. So he was able to identify that voice. Till Eli discerned that God was calling Samuel. So we must be patient with those who God has put under us to guide and to help them, to lead them to where God wants them to be. And we must be humble also. In the gospel, John the Baptist was humble to have allowed men he himself acquired for himself to go and meet the Master, to go and meet Jesus. He wasn't concerned about himself. He knew that these men needed Jesus. There is no need to block them. And let them go and meet Jesus who they are looking for. So, beloved in Christ, many people do not even know themselves. We don't know ourselves well. We need mentors. We need mediators to lead us. Nobody is able to help us to listen to the voice calling us every day. And we have to help people. So that voice speaking to us every morning, the voice that calls Samuel, calls us each morning whenever we wake up from our sleep. And God uses different things to speak to us. We want to pay attention to God. We need to listen to Him. We need to listen to God each day. To listen to God, we must ask the question Jesus asked in the gospel. We must ask that question this morning. What do you want? He asked the two disciples, "What do you want?" So this is the question we must ask every day when we wake up. Ask God, what do you want from me? Every morning when you wake up, ask God, what do you want from me? And if we are able to answer that, we change our life. What should I do today? You listen to God, and God will speak to you. God will remind you and remind us what you need to do. When we ask God, what do you want me to do? Each day, God will remind us of the promises we have made. If we don't ask what God wants from us, we can't know where we are going. So by asking God each day, what do you want me to do? What do you want from me? That we will be able to know where we are going. We will be moving, but sometimes we don't know where we are going because we have not asked God, what do you want from me? What do you want me to do? It's by asking God and by listening to Him that we'll be able to move to the direction of God. So we have to ask ourselves, what do I want? What do I want? What are the things that really give me joy? Are they the things of this world? Are they the material things? When we reflect on the things that give us joy, we will be able to journey well with God. So what are the things that give us joy? What do I want for life? What do I want? Am I happy living the life I'm leading now? So God, is this where you want me to be? So these are the questions we have to be asking. Am I supposed to be here instead of there? What do I want? If you ask this question, you know that you only can answer that. Deep within you, you're able to know your strength. You're able to know your weaknesses. So in listening to the voice of God, we must ask ourselves, what do I want? So when we are able to identify what we want, God will grant us our wishes. So we ask those God has put under us, what do you want with your life? Whoever God has put under your care and your direction and your guidance, you ask the person, what do you want with your life? And this is the question we must ask our children. What do you want? And how have you planned your life? We should ask them, what do you want to achieve with this thing you are doing now? We are to help our children, and we are to be mediators and the mentors. No matter how educated they are, and no matter how they have grown, they don't have that experience. Without us guiding them, they are not getting there. And so we have to guide them, and we have to help them. And there is nothing we will ever acquire. There is no knowledge we have that will be better than the advice coming from our parents. So our parents know the experiences, they know what is there, they know where the road is rough, they know where the road is smooth. They can guide us and they can direct us. So Eli said, Samuel, go and listen. Eli told Samuel, go and listen. So Eli didn't say, let me go and listen for you. He said, go and listen. So let us tell our children to listen for the voice of God. We are to guide them and do not force them to do anything. Be with them. Let us journey with our children. Let us entrust them with the hand of Almighty God. So let us listen to the voice of God first for ourselves, each day of our life, and let us help others to listen to that voice of God. Let us guide our family to listen to the voice of God. God is indeed communicating to us every day. When you listen to Him, you're able to receive new things from God. When you listen to Him, even in the midst of difficulties, you can see God in them. God, speak. I'm listening. Beloved in Christ, let us pay attention to God always, and we will see God communicating to us through the events of our daily lives. Let us pray for our children. Let us guide them. Let us lead them so that they will never go astray. Let us help them to achieve their dreams. Let them be mentors. Let them be mediators. And let us, above all, lead others to Christ for them to discover the voice of God. May the Lord today continue to guide us with that voice we hear every day, to follow in the direction and to be able to respect our bodies. And today, Paul is challenging us. He said, our bodies are not meant for fornication. The bodies are not meant for immorality. Our bodies are made to glorify God. Our bodies are not made for pornography. Our bodies are not made for sexual relations outside marriage. They are made to sing praises to God. So let us ask for the grace to respect our bodies. It says that the Spirit of God dwells in us. When we seek baptism, God made his home in our life. We should be reflecting God's glory in our life. Let us ask God always so that our bodies, our life, live for his own greater glory. Amen.
Made a move once before on my own. It was wrong.
I fell down.
Lord, you know how hard it was, but you picked me up and I learned be still. You know.